الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد Respected viewers, brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Today, everyone suffers from depression and all kinds of worries. Peace and contentment are gone. People are forced to use expensive drugs to get peace of mind, but still they can't get it normally. Allah Almighty, who is the creator of mankind, knows better about how to get inner peace and tranquility. So He declares in the Holy Quran in Surah Ar-Ra'd, verse number 28. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajeem. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alladheena amanu wa tatma'innu qulubuhum bi dhikrillah. Ala bi dhikrillah tatma'innul qulub. Sadaqallahu al-azim. Those who believed and whose hearts find rest in the remembrance of Allah. Verily, in the remembrance of Allah do hearts find rest. It is understood that the inventor of a machine knows exactly how to run it better. So to believe in Allah the Most High and by following the teachings of Islam can one achieve true success and the wealth of peace and contentment. An Abi Zarri radiallahu ta'ala anhu qal li Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ala adulluka ala kanzin min kunuzil jannah قلت بلى يا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله أو كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم It was narrated that Abu Zar said The Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said to me Shall I not tell you of a treasure which is one of the treasures of paradise. I said, yes, O Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. There is no power and no strength except with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. An Hazim ibn Harmala radiyallahu ta'ala anhu qala مررت بالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال لي يا حازم أكثر من قولي لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله فإنها من كنوز الجنة أو كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم It was narrated that Hazim bin Harmala said I passed by the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم And he said to me, O Hazim, say often, La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. There is no power and no strength except with Allah. For it is one of the treasures of paradise. Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu narrates that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Whoever reads La hawla wa la quwwata illa billahi al-aliyyil azim. It is a cure for 99 diseases and the most minor disease is stress. Read it at least 100 times daily. This hadith is found in Bukhari or Muslim. The meaning of this phrase There is no power and no strength except with Allah is a person's admission that he is unable to do anything without the help and support of Allah Almighty. No matter how great his power, energy and strength may become, a person still can't do anything without the help of Allah, who is above all of his creation, the most great, compared to whom nothing else is great. Every strong person is weak when compared with Allah Almighty. Every great person is insignificant and weak when compared with his might. This sentence is uttered when some serious matter befalls a person that he can't cope with, or there is something that it is very difficult for him to deal with. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "The one who recites Bismillah wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billahi al-aliyyil azim 10 times will be protected from 70 afflictions." It means the hardships, difficulties in life which descend from the heavens. Even such a disease like insanity, madness, one will be protected from these kind of punishments, afflictions. This hadith gives glad tidings of healing from 99 diseases to a faithful believer who recites this sacred kalima. And the lowest of them is depression. Other diseases have not been mentioned, but this is the reality that there are uncountable diseases in human body that can't be traced. But when one recites La hawla wa la quwwata illa billahi al-aliyyil azim, then he or she gets rid of these diseases. Abu Musa radhiyallahu anhu narrates that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Whoever reads La hawla wa la quwwata illa billahi al-aliyyil azim 100 times daily will never be dependent on the creation of Allah. May Allah Almighty give us power to recite this holy phrase every day. Ameen. Amma alayna illa al-balagh al-mubeen."